So welcome students. So in this question, you're given that B1, B2, B3 up to Bn are n terms of a GP. And B1 plus B2, the sum of first two terms is equal to 1. And the sum up to infinity, that is B1 plus B2 plus B3, so on up to infinity, is equal to 2. And the second term is less than 0. If that is so, what is the value of B1? That's the question. So now let us try to express the given information in terms of equations. So it's given that B1, B2, B3, so on up to Bn are in GP. So let us assume that there is a common ratio R. So let R be the common ratio. So if R is the common ratio, what is B2? So B2 becomes B1 into R. So the first equation becomes B1 plus B1 R is equal to 1. That is B1 times 1 plus R is equal to 1. Right? So B1 plus B2 will become B1 times R. And this is the first information that is given. And the second information is sigma of infinite terms is equal to 2. Starting from B1, B2, B3, so on up to B infinity is equal to 2. So now what is the sum up to infinite terms? The sum up to infinite terms is A by 1 minus R. First term by 1 minus R is the sum up to infinity. So what is this expression? This expression is nothing but first term B1 by 1 minus R is equal to 2. So B1 into 1 plus R is equal to 1. B1 by 1 minus R is equal to 2. So if you combine these two informations, so let us divide one with the other. So B1 times 1 plus R by B1 by 1 minus R is equal to 1 by 2. So this B1 and B1 is getting cancelled. So this 1 minus R goes up. So 1 minus R square is equal to 1 by 2. This implies R square is equal to 1 by 2. This implies R is equal to plus or minus 1 by root 2. So R can be either plus 1 by root 2 or minus 1 by root 2. So now, if R is plus 1 by root 2, so what is the value of B1? So B1 is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by root 2. That is equal to root 2 by root 2 plus 1. So as you can see, this is not the case which is being asked in this question. Because if B1, if R is plus 1 by root 2, B1 is turning out to be positive. And R is positive, B1 is positive. So B2, which is B1 into R, is also positive. But in the question, it's given that B2 is negative. That means the common ratio has to be negative. So my R has to be minus 1 by root 2. So now let us substitute minus 1 by root 2. You get B1 is equal to 1 by 1 minus 1 by root 2. That is equal to root 2 by root 2 minus 1. So root 2 by root 2 minus 1. So this will be the required answer. But if you want to rationalize it, you can rationalize it by multiplying it with root 2 plus 1. So if you multiply it with root 2 plus 1, so the denominator will become 2 minus 1 and the denominator will become 1. The numerator will become root 2 into 2 is root 2 into root 2 is 2 plus root 2. So this can also be a valid answer. Thank you.